Welcome to our glass plate. Today we're going to do an example that concerns terminal velocity. Let's think about the velocity of a hailstone coming down. Let me first draw for you the hailstone. Here it is. I draw a pretty big one because we're not going to solve this problem for a small one. Our hailstone has a diameter of about 5 centimeters. And the question we want to answer is, it's coming down at a terminal velocity. Should we be afraid of walking outside with these hailstones, or is it not that bad? We learn from the theory that the terminal velocity is governed by the forces acting on the hailstone. So let me put in the forces. Gravity, the obvious one. Buoyancy, and the force that we now learned, drag. These three forces govern the terminal velocity of our hailstone. And I can write down the starting equation. The drag force upwards and the buoyancy upwards are balanced by gravity pointing downwards. For each of these three forces, I need detailing in terms of unknown and known parameters. Let's start with the drag. We know that we can model this as CD, perpendicular area, and half rho of the air times V terminal squared. Buoyancy, I'm going to ignore because it's pretty small compared to the other ones. Gravity can be written as the mass of the hailstone times G. And rather than the mass, I prefer to use the density of a hailstone times the volume times G. These two forces should balance, and that should give the terminal velocity. Before solving this, I need to think about whole terms. Which do I know? Which do I not know? Let's start here. Everything known here. Density on the order of 900 kilo per cubic meter. Volume of a sphere, I know because I know the diameter. G, gravity's acceleration known. On this side, the perpendicular area, pi over 4 d squared, because it's a sphere. Rho of the air, on the order of 1 kilo per cube. Terminal velocity, obviously not known, I need to know that. The catch is in the drag coefficient. We know that this is a function of the Reynolds number, and thus a function of that unknown terminal velocity. That creates a problem. We can solve this by iterative methods, but I'm going to use here some a priori knowledge. I know that this hailstone will come down at a reasonably high velocity, and I can thus anticipate that we are in a high Reynolds regime. If I draw my graph Reynolds versus the drag coefficient on a log-log scale, it looks something like this. I can assume that I'm in this area. Later on, we need to check that, of course. This would mean that the drag coefficient itself is 0.4. Once I have the drag coefficient, now I can equate explicitly the terminal velocity. And the terminal velocity reads as 4/3 GD stemming from here cube of D and here only. The square of D divided by CD times the density of a hailstone over the density of air, and out of this, the square root, as this is a squared equation. In this one, we know G, we know D, we have estimated CD. I know the hailstone density, I know the hailstone density, so we can compute everything. Do it yourself, and you will find out that this is on the order of 35 meters a second. You better stay inside.